Welcome to my crib. Come on in. Now this area, this is my wardrobe area. But the main thing you gotta focus on over here is my sound system. This thing can bump. Do you think about me now and then? Yeah. Do you think about me now and then? And this is my bed! Where the magic happens. The best part about this bed is... it's got a... feather mattress. But just in case I get tired of this bed, I got 10 other beds in my crib. This is my bathroom. I got double sinks with silver fixtures, and this water never stops running. And this is my kitchen. It's got a nice wraparound porch, seating for about 200. Needless to say, I don't cook much, but it's a nice place to enjoy. This is my pool. 38 feet long, 5 foot deep, and every day from 4 to 5, I'm allowed to swim in it. These are my 48 cars, but this one right here, this is my baby. Check out those rims! These are my courts. This is where I ball it up, day in and day out. This is my campfire. You know, it's real nice at the end of the day to come home, get around with your family, and have a nice big barbecue. And on that note, I'm kicking y'all out. See ya. Peace.
Let me tell you, oh my friend, about this joy I'm living in. Let me take the mic, I wanna testify how I was dead and then I came to life. No more living in the dark of night, no, everything's alright. I've been changed.
Look right here. This is a licorice bush, only found right here at Camp Nawakwa. Very delicious things. In Native American, licorice literally means delicious red twisted fruit. Some of these.
They look like Twizzlers.
Right, they do kind of look like Twizzlers, but they'll be good sustenance through the night. Using the tools we found earlier, your broom, my jacket, this is a great hideout because you see the natural way it's already formed, and it shelters us from the sick people above.
You know there's a cabin right over there.
No, this will do much better for the night. Sean, go ahead in. Right, now it's going to get very cold at night, so we're going to have to huddle together for warmth.
All right, we're bedded down for the night in our camp that we've built.
Flex, why couldn't we have used the rabbit fur?
Right, body heat is much better than rabbit fur for keeping warm at night, Sean. Just last year, two campers almost died from being too cold in their cabins at night.
It's not even that cold out.
Don't worry, it'll be okay, Sean.
My name is Fox Grills. I've spent a lifetime learning how to prepare and survive in dangerous and difficult situations. I've been as far south as the rainforest of Peru to the glaciers in the North Country. I've had to survive on various foods found throughout my journeys and treks across this wild planet. I've eaten things as rare as kangaroo and squid, and also once ate an entire peanut butter pie. I'm here this week at Confirmation Camp to teach you the skills and techniques you'll need to survive for an entire week-long journey. This is Man vs. Camp.
Well, as you can see, it wasn't the greatest night, but we made it through. Sean, let's move on. Right, Sean, look out! And that is a Pennsylvania black snake. But right now, we've had our fill of licorice, so we don't want to be greedy. So let's move along. But when you do, run in circles, because it fools the snakes. Let's go, mate. All right, look what I've noticed here. This right here is counselor poo. You can tell because of its sheer size and volume, perhaps from someone as large as Tzak. This poo is full of vitamins and nutrients which will help keep us and sustain us throughout confirmation camp. And just like elephant dung, it contains a lot of water. When you need it, you can squeeze it to get the juices out.
All right, Sean, let's try it. Admittedly, it's not the best, but it will do in a pinch.
Here we go, Sean. Have at it, man.
You're right, man.
Now, with all the seeds and nutrients in there, it is tough for first timers. Not every poo is delicious. Let's move along. Just last year, three campers died from the disgusting contents of their body after not showering till Saturday morning. So we're going to take a bath. This water is 30 degrees below Celsius. That's very, very cold. That's fine, Sean. Excellent. Now, when I go in, I will give you the international distress symbol when I want to get out. It looks like this. All right? Ready?
Ready.
Let's get clean. That's really cold. Really, really cold. It's very important to get your body heat backflowing through your body. Put your arms up. Warm me up, man. Yeah, get in there good and warm it up. That's perfect. Now, take off your wet clothes so that you can get warmer with some general exercising regimen.
Oh, yeah, we're gonna stand over here.
Some of this will help out immensely. All right, Sean, that should do, at least for now. Let's move it along. I need every power I have to attract the ladies, and this will definitely work to get us rescued. Sean, where is the rubber ball to throw up as a signal?
I don't have it.
Give me the cone then. We'll do the best we have with improvisation. Let's hope this works. Great, I think they've seen our signal and they'll definitely come soon. After a rigorous day of testing, it turns out Sean Hoffman is not ready for staff here at Confirmation Camp. Shortly after this filming, unfortunately, he passed on. Our prayers are with you, Sean.
Good evening, everybody. I hope you've had a wonderful week at camp. It's already Friday. It's crazy how quick it goes, but I hope your journey this week was awesome. Today I'm going to be talking to you about sainthood and also the power of God. And to start off that, I'm going to read from 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verses 6 through 9. So we are always full of courage. We know that as long as we are at home in the body, we are away from the Lord's home. For our life is a matter of faith, not of sight. We are full of courage and would much prefer to leave our home in the body and be at home with the Lord. More than anything else, however, we want to please Him, whether in our home, here, or there. One of the main things that I take from this would be, for our life is a matter of faith, not of sight. God will give you the strength to get through anything, and that's His power to you. He'll show you His power by giving you strength to get through anything you feel may cause doubt in your life. He will help you get through that. I face stuff in my life already that He has brought me to be a stronger person. Just to give you a little example, I became a type 1 diabetic back my freshman year in high school, and I know there's no way I could have got through that without the power of Christ. And when I was in a time of doubt for that first second, when I was like, what is this disease? Am I gonna die? I didn't know what to expect. The only thing I could turn to was my faith. And I had to put all my faith in Him that He would help me become a stronger person to get through this. And that's the person I've become today. It's helped shape my life because of what He has helped me do. And being a servant, and a saint, you want to help other people. And that's one thing I like to do, is to give back to others, because I want them to experience the same things that I feel. And just to give you another example, in our cabin Tuesday night after comp line, we had a tremendous experience. We came right from comp line, stayed serious, went right into candle prayer, and all of us just kind of like opened up and we let God in. And it was one of the most amazing experiences I've ever had. It's literally indescribable. And as we went through the candle prayer and we prayed and then went into some songs, some worship songs, everybody sang very loud. It was amazing just to experience everybody singing so loud, because when you have a group of five or six people, they don't really want to sing loud. And everybody was up and singing very loud, and everybody felt the grace of God on them. And that's one of those things that I told them, Alex Holmes and I told them, that, hey, feel this right now. This is Him. This is what it's all about. We like to experience this. And not only here, but take it with you when you go home. Because if you can do this here and at home, you'll be strong. And that's very powerful to have. If you can change lives at home, you can. That's the world to it. And it's very awesome to have that feeling. And just to give you one last little thing, I wrote something on my arm because of the way that I saw images last night. It inspired me to do this. So this is my last message to you guys.
There's a cause that's very near and dear to all of our hearts that we really need to talk about.
Pay close attention, because it's sweeping the nation. And it affects not one, not two, not three, but every single one of you.
That's right. We're talking about food babies.
Stop laughing. This isn't funny. This is for real.
We all have them, but nobody. Nobody wants to talk about them. It's really sad. Don't be embarrassed. We all have them.
Nobody should have to go around their whole life trying to hide the food baby. Just want everybody to know it's okay.
If you love your food baby, you'll love yourself.
Let your inner food baby come out.
Remember, it's important to note, this does not include only food babies, but also water babies. Because sometimes, well, we're thirsty, and we fill up. And I just want you to know, you are not alone in this.
If you'd like to join our cause, please visit our website at foodbabyawarenessassociation.com.
Hashtag, release the baby.
When you eat your snacks, you can't make any sounds. You have to be quiet. If you make any noise, the staff will come and get you.
This world is an imperfect place.
Everywhere there is brokenness.
Every day brings new challenges and new fears.
We cannot let any obstacles overcome us.
Where can we find strength?
Where can we find hope?
Where can I feel that I am not alone?
In God.
Through Jesus Christ.
With the Holy Spirit working within us.
We are powerful beyond measure.
We are many and we are one.
Individually, we are incomplete.
Together, we are more than individuals.
So let love flow freely.
and let it change this world and all its people.
This will not be easy.
And it takes each and every one of us.
Let no one be left behind.
So make it happen.
Not tomorrow,
but today.
And every day.
Be bold.
Embrace awkwardness.
Be brave.
Overcome your fears.
Speak up and let your voice be heard.
We will not be a silent generation.
We are God's hands in this world.
Be the difference that makes a difference.
Live love.
Live Christ.
That the staff are like the celebrities of camp. And just like celebrities, the things that get tweeted at them aren't always the nicest. So we found some tweets online this week, and we asked some staff to read mean tweets about themselves.
Zach Stank is the world's largest toddler.
Nate Young's facial hair looks like chocolate sprinkles glued to his face.
Good thing camp is during the summer because you can't see at Jen Joyce in the snow. Hashtag pasty? That's just mean.
Hey, at the Tom Stank. Thanks for all the cool 80s movie references. You know, long before we were born. Pound sign clueless. Really? Really? That's the best you got?
At Scoot Scoot, quit acting like your staff. You're barely a deacon.
Alex Holmes does nothing on staff. No, I'm not staff, I'm a disciple. I actually do things, okay? Staff.
Justin Holmes is only the second hottest staff member. Really?
That's right.
Maine Wilson. Ew.
Jay Eggman's the hairiest pathfinder I've ever seen. I do have a good 5 o'clock shadow.
Michael Williams looks like the love child of Jonah Hill, Melissa McCarthy, and Seth Rogen.
At Sarah Fogg, sings as good as she paints. Terrible.
Aaron Forger makes a better counselor than staff member. I guess that's why they demoted him. Hashtag 4 more years.
Only Jesse Woodrow's muscle shirts remember how big his muscles were? Hashtag no hammer?
What? What?
Elizabeth Peter is so short, the Pathfinders asked her how the weather is down there.
And like, it's cold. It's really cold down here. And it's getting
more and more absurd. As you can see, even though most of them are old and out of touch, staff members have feelings too. So, think before you tweet.
Yep. So we've lived in a place where people believe what we believe, and share love freely, and accept each other for who we are. But where do we go from here? How should we live when we leave this place?
Love from the center of who you are.
Run for dear life from evil. Hold on for dear life to good.
Be good friends who love deeply.
Practice serving others. Don't expect others to serve you.
Don't burn out. Keep yourself fueled and on fire.
Actively look for ways you can serve God.
Don't quit in hard times. Pray all the harder.
Help fellow Christians and be creative in making them feel at home.
Bless your enemies.
No cursing under your breath.
Laugh with your friends when they're happy and share tears when they're down.
Get along with each other. Don't be stuck up.
Make friends with nobodies. Don't be the great somebody.
Don't hit back.
See beauty in everyone and everything.
Do your best and get along with everybody.
Don't insist on getting even. That's not for you to do. God will have the final say.
If you see someone that is hungry, get them food. If you see them thirsty, get them water.
Surprise people with random acts of kindness.
Don't let evil get the best of you. Get the best of evil by doing good.
So don't give up. And don't forget that everywhere you go, you take us with you. And use that knowledge to help you live a life that's without limits. And every day, live love.
So may you begin to see in yourself the giftedness that God has entrusted within you. And may you be filled with the strength, courage, and commitment that comes from the Holy Spirit. And may you use them to be God's hands and do His work in the world. And may you always remember and never forget that you are a blessed child of God who is empowered each day to do great things for the greater glory of our Heavenly Father. God is love. Peace.
Salutary, I would say, means, you know,
awesome and worthy of salutation.
Correct.
Not unlike saluting. I salute you, Jesus, as we eat your body.
And drink your blood.
Well, in my opinion, I think when it says it is indeed right and salutary, it means that it is meant to be. It is ordained. It's gonna happen. Good. It is good.
Oh, it's good.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
So basically you're just making this up. You have no idea what it means.
No, absolutely not. No, we know exactly what it is.
That is absolutely what it means.
Yeah, right. Absolutely.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. You would swear to that.
I would. I would bet Sarah's life on it.
It almost sounds like when you're really thirsty and you salivate.
Oh.
It's like you're thirsty for baptism.
Oh, so it is indeed right and you're thirsty to get a drink, is what you're saying.
Pretty much.
How many youth from your congregation do you have here with you this week?
We have 10 here this week.
Out of those, give me a percentage. How many do you think you know the word, the definition of the word salutary?
Salutary? I don't know. I wouldn't bet that any of them could tell you salutary.
Zero. Zero right, percent probably. Is what you're saying. Yeah.
I may be doing you wrong, guys, but prove me wrong if you know what it means.
I think that's very common around this camp.
Yep. Okay. Yeah, no.
So. Okay, nothing. Got nothing here. All right, thanks.
All right, well, I think salutary, stemming from salute, would mean to, you know, pay respect to in a reverent manner.
Okay. So, it has something to do with saluting, you would think.
I would say so.
So, perhaps it's a military term.
Yeah, well, absolutely.
Okay, so that's what you're going to go in right now and you're going to teach the NBCs that.
Yep.
I think that's something that they define in the four pages of the Book of Esther, which is probably why I never learned it.
Probably. Hey, could you give us an example of the word then, salutary, in a sentence that does not start with, it is indeed right and?
I have eaten a salutary piece of pizza before.
Would you think that's something you would say often?
Well, it depends how often I eat pizza.
Maybe you want to apologize to the hundreds of young people who are just hoping that they learn good things here.
Well, obviously they're not going to learn them
down.
It from me.
You've let them down, haven't you?
Guess I'm not coming back next year.
Yeah.
Sorry, camp.
You're Mysteries. A teacher, right?
Yes.
Now, are you a real teacher or are you like an art teacher or something like that?
No, I am a real teacher.
Oh, okay.
Of fifth graders.
Oh, all right. Ooh, you need to be smarter than a fifth grader.
In fact, I think I am than a fifth grader.
Well, we'll soon find out.
Okay.
Sometimes I find that when I'm having trouble understanding something, like a word, that if I can use it or hear it being used in a sentence.
There you go.
It can make sense to me.
Right.
So can you please use the word salutary in a sentence that does not begin with the phrase, it is indeed right and?
Salutary. I gave a salutary greeting to my friends.
A salutary greeting to my friends. What exactly does salutary mean, by the way?
I think it means like a salutation, like hello, salutation.
Oh, so you think it means that, is what you said, I believe, just a second ago, right?
That's just, God just spoke through me.
I asked you the question, and you said, I think it means, which means you're just kind of just pulling this out of somewhere right now, aren't you?
Yep.
This stuff.
Salutary.
It is indeed right and salutary that we should at all times and in all places.
It's not just knowing the words. Sometimes it's knowing what the words mean that help form sentences and conversation.
It's Friday
and
of camp.
Dialogue, yeah.
Okay, salutary. I would think it means holy. Holy would be part of it.
Holy,
salutary, like commanded by Christ to do.
That's good. Always right work Jesus salutary. Into your answer and it's right, kids?
Indeed,
you know?
Right and salutary. Holy.
I don't think saying it over and over is going to help you come up with the meaning of the word.
Salutary. It is.
Certainly somewhere in seminary this came up.
I'm sure it did. I'm sure it did.
All right.
Maybe I wasn't there that day.
Okay. All right.
It
well.
Is indeed right and salutary that we did it all times. I'm just trying to.
Can you name one person in camp who might know the answer
did
to this question?
Steve Pelzer.
Steve Pelzer. So a former director might know.
Salutary. Well, I think when it's a salutation, you're addressing someone. So I would think salutary means that we are addressing God with our preface. It's in the preface. So a salutation is when you address someone. So salutary
so then
be maybe indeed right in salutary. Salutary. I don't know. Holy, proper.
Holy.
Proper.
Proper.
Holy.
Okay.
Commanded.
All right, we're
going to
stick with that one, I think.
Holy
I think
proper.
That's going to be the one we're going to go. But I think we're going to have to go to ask Steve Bowser evidently.
I'll go look it up and get back to you. Okay, can I phone a friend?
There is no such thing. You've used
but
up.
I can run
years
and look
ago.
It up.
Years ago, you used up all your phone friends and polled the audience and, you know, 50-50 and all of those. They were gone.
It's Friday of camp.
Long time ago.
That part of my memory, I can't find that file.
Okay. All right. Well, the search
I'm
continues.
I'm sorry, Holy Trinity Youth. Forgive me. Do me again.
A chance to redeem herself. We're all about second chances. Yesterday was reconciliation. That's not today, though. Today is Friday.
God is
Friday. Is Friday reconciliation day?
Well, it's...
No, it's not, is it?
But it's always
reconciliation day
for us.
You had your chance. Sorry.
It's sacrilegious.
No.
It's beneficial.
You had your chance. I'm turning off the camera now.
Health-giving.